Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolo Tech, and I wanted to show you how to downgrade from iOS 16 to iOS 15 properly without losing any data. I'll show you step by step how to do that, whether you're using an iOS 16 beta or maybe iOS 16 has been released and you want to go down to a previous version. You'll be able to do that as long as Apple is signing the current versions of iOS. Sometimes Apple stops signing them and you'll no longer be able to downgrade to them, but for now we'll be able to downgrade to iOS 15 or any subsequent version of iOS 16. And the first thing you'll need is a Mac or Windows computer. And you'll need a Mac running the latest version of macOS or a Windows computer running the latest version of iTunes. You'll also need an Apple ID and password. So you'll need that once we restore the phone to put that back in to activate the phone or unlock it. Also, a quick word of warning, if you're running watchOS 9 and you downgrade to iOS 15, typically you'll lose connectivity completely to the device. So you want to make sure that you are aware of this, and also you can't easily downgrade watchOS 9 to watchOS 8 without bringing it to Apple to have them do that. So keep that in mind. If you do have watchOS 9, you probably want to stay on iOS 16. Also, make sure you have a backup, as when we restore this, it will completely wipe everything off the device. So just keep that in mind. And the first thing is, if you're using iCloud, it's pretty simple because everything just syncs. So if you go into settings, tap on your name at the top, then tap on iCloud, depending on what you have turned on, it will just sync to the new phone anyway, once it's restored, or maybe if you're moving to a different phone. So you'll see I have photos turned on, iCloud Drive, iCloud Mail, all my passwords and keychain. Under Show All, you can see here all my notes, messages, health data, contacts, calendars, reminders, Safari, news, stocks, home, fitness, wallet, game center, and Siri, as well as different apps. All of that data is saved to iCloud if you have this turned on. So this is really simple and easy, and you can verify some of this data, such as photos, on iCloud.com. So if you want to make sure it's already backed up there, make sure you have all of these turned on, or you create a backup first. So if we go back one page, go down to iCloud Backup, you'll see it's turned on. Make sure you make a backup now or have one before. But all of your messages, as long as they're turned on in iCloud settings, all of those will sync anyway. But just make sure you have a backup. I typically recommend making a backup of the current version anyway. If you want to bump back up to iOS 16 later, you'll have this backup to pick from. Now, in order to restore this to iOS 15, you can't just simply plug it in and hit restore in iTunes or in the Finder on a Mac. What you'll actually need to do is put this into recovery mode, because you need to download the last version. So unless you have an IPSW file, which is the full install file for the iPhone, you'll need to put it into recovery mode. And it's pretty simple to do that. So first, what we want to do is take our lightning cable and plug it into our computer, and then plug it into our iPhone. You'll see it's connected, it's charging, and it's asking me if I want to trust the computer. Tap on trust, put in your password or passcode, and then we can move on. Now you'll see in Finder, just scroll down on the left here, it shows my iPhone, and then we need to click trust. Once we've clicked trust, we should be good to go, and then it will connect next time when we need it to. Now also keep in mind, if this is on an iTunes, on a Windows computer, it will also be on the left here as well. Now you'll see we can click on restore iPhone, but this won't work because we don't currently have iOS 16 easily available to download through this. So we need to have it in restore mode. Now, in order to put our phone into recovery mode so we can restore it, press volume up, volume down, press and hold the power sleep wake button. So I'll do this in real time. So up, down, press and hold, and then keep holding until it reboots, and then continue to hold until you get to the restore options. So you'll see here, it's still saying slide to power off. It's rebooting. I'm still holding with my finger. We'll wait just a moment and it will reboot into the recovery mode options. So we'll wait just a moment here. It's still rebooting. I'm still holding with the power sleep wake button, still holding it down. And now you'll see a computer with a lightning cable. On the computer itself, on my Mac here, you'll see it says there's a problem with the iPhone that requires it to be updated or restored. And now we can just click on restore. However, if we made a mistake and we want to reboot, we don't want to continue and restore everything, we can do that by unplugging our iPhone and repeating those same steps. Volume up, volume down, press and hold the power sleep wake button, and it will go back into the normal boot mode. So I'll show you this again in real time. I'm still pressing and holding on the power sleep wake button. Once it reboots and we see the Apple, we can let go. So now if we want to restore it, we'll go back and repeat those same steps. Volume up, volume down, press and hold after we've plugged in the lightning cable. The lightning cable is what makes the difference here. So again, wait until your computer recognizes it. So volume up, volume down, press and hold the power sleep wake button until it reboots and shows you the recovery mode again. Now that it's showing the recovery mode, we go over to our Mac or our computer and then just simply click on restore. It'll take just a moment. You'll see here we have the option to restore, but it will take a moment pop up on the screen. Are you sure you want to restore the iPhone? We'll click on restore and update. Give it just a moment here. And now it will ask us to install the latest version that's available of iOS 15. So in this case, 15.5, it could be 15.6 or 15.7. Go ahead and click on next, then click on agree. It will take a little while, and this depends on your internet connection. You'll see here, this is a pretty large file at 6.55 gigabytes, and it will take about 18 minutes or so to download. Depending on your internet connection, this could be faster or slower. Now the iPhone has been restored. It's taking about 8 minutes or so to fully restore it, and then it has to boot again where you'll have a little progress bar here. So it could take anywhere from 8 to 12 minutes or so. It depends on your computer after you've downloaded the actual restore image file. So this can take a little bit of time, and we'll come back when it's done. Now the iPhone has been restored and it says that it's locked to owner. So we can unplug the cable and then swipe up. And if you have a different phone nearby, you can quickly set it up that way, or we'll just set it up manually here, where we'll tap on our language, select your language, select your country, and then go into setup manually or bring a different device that you already have near it, whether that be an iPad, an iPhone, or something else. We'll set it up manually for this demonstration, and then we'll connect it to a network. Once you're connected to a network, tap on next and wait for the next step. Now again, it's going to say that it's locked to owner. So we'll need to put in our username and password for iCloud. So go ahead and do that. As long as you put in the correct username and password, it will go to the next screen where it says data and privacy. Tap on continue. Now this is where you'll set up Face ID or Touch ID. So we'll do that. And now Face ID is set up. Tap on continue. And now you can create a passcode. Once you're past the passcode setup, now we have the option to restore from an iCloud backup, Mac or PC, transfer directly from another iPhone, move from Android, or don't transfer and just set it up as a new device. In this case, we'll restore from an iCloud backup. So we'll do that. We'll have to put in our iCloud ID and password again. Then we'll have to agree to terms. And it will take a moment to set this up, and it will look for your backup. Now, as you can see, our different backups here, and in this case, I actually can pick the one I made while I was on iOS 16. So just tap on that one, and we'll go to the next screen where we can make this your new phone. Just tap continue, then keep it up to date. Just tap continue. You don't have another option. And now it will restore from iCloud. This can take quite some time depending on your internet connection and more. So it'll say estimated here. It could say anywhere from 5 minutes to 2 hours. It just depends on your internet connection. Give it some time and then come back when it's finished. Now it took just under 13 minutes for it to fully restore. Again, this depends highly on your internet connection. So now we're at the main screen. It's going to take a moment for everything to start up again, and it will start installing all of your different apps. So all of the things that were synced across iCloud, whether that be messages or mail or music, will start to be brought back to the iPhone now that it's restored. All of your apps you had before, the same layout you had on your home screen, and everything else. So you can see all of the different apps here. They're sort of grayed out, and we're waiting for them to install. So this will take a little while, again, depending on your internet connection, which phone it is, depending on its speed overall, and more. So as you can see, it's restoring everything now, and now you're back to iOS 15. If you go into your settings, go to general and about, you can see that we're on the latest version of iOS that's available. So if this is iOS 15.6 or 15.7, if that ever comes out, or by the time you're watching this video, you could even use this method to roll back to iOS 16 versions. And so that's how you restore everything. All of your different history, contacts, and more will all be brought back from the backup, and then everything will sync from iCloud back to your messages and more. And so everything's syncing right now. It will take a while, and it will process everything in the background. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.